Now about the practice of yoga. Patanjali gives us the aphorisms which teaches the practice of yoga. First aphorism, he says, I am going to give you the instructions of yoga practice. So he gives us only practical instructions and not at all any discourses or philosophy. Some people have wrongly translated the first aphorism as a discourse on yoga, but it is not discourse. Patanjali uses what he calls anushasana. Anushasana means instruction. It is sometimes translated as discourse, but it is not correct. And in the second aphorism, he defines what yoga is. The definition is like this. Yoga is to suspend. This is the definition of yoga given by Patanjali. The mind and the senses put together are called chitta in Sanskrit. And the reactive nature is called vritti in Sanskrit. So, the vritti of chitta is suspended. And he teaches us how to suspend this. That is, how to suspend the activity of the senses and mind. And then he says, what happens when we suspend this? In the third aphorism, he teaches us what happens when we suspend this. He says, then the indweller lives in his original state. That is, the indweller lives in his lost state. This is what happens when your practice of yoga is completed. If not, what happens? That is what he gives in the next aphorism, that is fourth aphorism. He says, if not practiced, he lives as the activity of his reaction. So you have no original existence in that state. You have only the existence of your activity. That is, suppose when I am looking at the light, I exist only in the form of light in my mind, not in my form. And I am listening to his voice, I exist only in the form of voice and not myself. So, to stop this, and to have the original state of existence is the purpose of yoga practice. And when we begin to practice it, we begin to live as ourselves. Then, how to practice it? Two activities should be introduced. Neutralize the reactive activity. The first thing to introduce is repeatedly propose the Lord consciousness in you. That is, you should propose that the I am in the mind should go to the I am in the heart. You should propose that you should live with the Lord in the heart. Not enough. It's not enough. Repeat the proposal. You should repeat the proposal not in your mind and thought, but in every incident of your daily life. Whatever you do, you should do to make the Lord felt by you. So, there should be a constant proposal of Lord consciousness in you. Unless we have a continuous taste for better living, a continuous test for Lord consciousness, there is no yoga practice. So this is the first thing we have to practice. In Sanskrit it is called abhyasa. Sometimes it is wrongly translated as repetition. As practice. The meaning of the word is repetition and not practice. So you should repeatedly apply the mind to the Lord consciousness. The Lord consciousness in everyone around you.